Delmar Loop Trolley shut down in December after it could not get enough passengers to ride it, and it ran out of money to operate. In the end, the trolley that cost taxpayers $51 million lasted just over a year. At this council meeting, Councilman Ernie Trakas had sharp words against a proposal by Bi-State's CEO to get the trolley rolling again.
Overwhelming response from the members of the county, residents of the county, is that they're not in favor of funding that trolley anymore, and I don't blame them.
Under the Bi-State CEO's plan, the agency would make the trolley part of Bi-State. It would pay for the first 4 years of operation with federal grants and money from a special taxing district set up to run the trolley. But the CEO admits that after 4 years, local governments may have to kick in extra dollars. St. Louis County funds the lion's share of Bi-State's budget.
But Bi-State's on notice right now that if they come back before the council and ask for money to subsidize the loop trolley in a year or two or four from now, the answer is going to be a resounding no. They're not going to get the money. So if they want to carve into their own budget to the tune of $1 million a year, that's up to Bi-State.
I caught up with Bi-State CEO Talby Roach.
So you support Bi-State taking over the loop trolley?
So within the context of the deal that has negotiated, there is merit to it that is associated with avoiding default with a federal government entity.
Do you know for a fact that the federal government would deny us more money if the loop trolley fails?
I do not know for a fact.
Councilwoman Lisa Clancy has just been picked to head the council. I questioned the new councilwoman about this deal.
What are your thoughts about possibility that Bi-State could take over the loop trolley? As you know, Ernie Trakas's position, what's your position?
You know, I share a lot of the concerns that my colleague Councilman Trake has shared, and I know that this is something that Bi-State has given a lot of thought to, which I think is really important. And I hope that they will continue to give it thought, but also to listen to folks in the community who have been, very concerned about that and concerned about more public money going to this project.
There is a Bi-State meeting on the 24th of this month where commissioners will discuss what to do about this deal. We'll, of course, let you know what happens. After all, you paid for it.
So are Bi-State commissioners on board at this point?
Not all of them. It's a split. The two Madison County commissioners, they are dead set against it. Some others are on the fence and some in favor it. So we really don't know how this is all going to shake out. We may find out at this meeting on the 24th. So right now, still up in the air.
All right, we shall see. Elliot, thank you. Well,